today is a step tutorial. We will be learning how to do the Maxie Ford. Now, this step is named after someone named Maxie Ford, so it's not like a giant step, although it can be, because you hear Maxie, you think like a huge thing. It's not a big step per se. It is one used a lot in musical theater, I would say, but so it does have that it can be big element, but it is named after someone named Maxie Ford, just to clarify that. So a Maxie Ford has four components, and it's a little similar to the buffalo, but it's not. And I like to be very like distinguishing about that. It is similar, but it is not the same. So it has four elements. You step with your right foot, you shuffle with your left foot, then you jump onto your left foot, and then you drop, holding onto my mantle, then you drop your toe on the floor. You tap it on the floor. Bing. It doesn't stay. A toe is not an into the ground motion. It is an up motion. You strike the floor and it has to come up so that the sound resonates. Just to clarify about a toe. So you have step, you have shuffle, jump to the other foot, toe. So it's those four things. Step, shuffle, jump, toe. Do that one more time on the right. Just to make sure. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, shuffle, jump, jump. Okay, now that we have those four parts on the right side, let's do it on the left side. So we have step, left foot, then your right foot does the shuffle, then you jump on it, and then you tap. So it's left foot step, shuffle right, jump on it, one more time. You have step left, shuffle right, jump, tap. So, the rhythm, it goes step, shuffle, jump, tap. This is a waltz step. It has four things, but it is performed over three counts. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. One, two, three. One, two. Now you can do this step to any song. The song can be in 4-4, the song can be in 7-8, for all that matters, but it only takes up three beats. So when you're just learning it on its own, it's gonna sound like a waltz. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. But I promise it can be done in all kinds of scenarios. I will even show you one in this video, which is in 4, not 3. So it goes 1, 2, and 3. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. So let's try that together. It's going to be a little quick. It'll go step, shuffle, jump, tap. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, and 3. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. One more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. Let's try the left foot. So you step with the left foot first. That's why it's on the left side. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. One more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. Again. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to do two in a row. I can tap so much better than I can talk today. All right, so two in a row, which means it's in three. It's not going to have a break in between. It's going to go step, shuffle, jump, tap. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. Right away, okay? Two on the right. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, shuffle, jump, tap. Step, shuffle, jump, toe. Step, shuffle, seven, eight. Step, shuffle, jump toe. Step, shuffle, jump toe. Okay, so now we're going to do a pattern. You're going to do exactly what you just did, but at the end of that, you're going to go stamp, up. And then your left foot's free and you're going to go on the left. Worst that happens is you mess up, right? Cool. So the pattern goes like this. One, and two, and three, four, and five, and six, seven, eight. One, and two, and three, four, and five, and six, seven, eight. Now, I said this in the Buffalo video, I'm gonna say it in this one. I forgot to say it before. Make sure you finish your shuffle before you jump to the other side. When you're doing a Buffalo, shuffle. Finish that whole shuffle before you even think about jumping. And you have to finish the shuffle. Because what happens a lot is that people go, and then as they do their shuffle, they've already thrown their weight over. And then you don't have time to finish your shuffle. So you have to keep your weight centered on that standing leg. And shuffle. And then jump over. And hold on to your mantelpiece for dear life. All right, so now that we've clarified that, make sure you're finishing your shuffle. Always, always, always. So let's do this pattern. So it goes one, and two, and three, four, and five, and six, seven, eight, one, and two, and three, four, and five, and six, seven, eight. So let's try it together. Five, six, seven, eight, one, and then I will show you one more thing, then we're good. Five, six, seven, eight. One, and two, and three, four, and five, and six, seven, eight. One, and two, and three, four, and five, and six, seven, eight. Awesome. Now, just like the buffalo, this can turn, which is awesome. But I will say what I said in the Buffalo video, just in case you didn't watch that one. Turning does not change the step. And I'm saying this to be very clear with you and with myself in these situations. Turning does not change what your feet do. Your feet do not stop exactly what they were just doing. You are simply rotating your body as you do it. So the feet do not change. You might have to tell yourself that a lot. Happens to me all the time where I get a step and then somebody goes, oh, we're gonna turn this. I have to look in the mirror and go, Jen, the feet don't change, okay? And then my reflection looks back at me like, yeah, I know. And then we get it wrong anyway. So it's been a long day. Maybe I'm just being crazy. So let's do turning. Let me show you how this works. So again, your feet go step, shuffle, jump. Left foot is doing the shuffle. Right foot is doing the toe, okay? So you step right, you already start rotating. Now, I'm spotting so that I don't get dizzy, so my face is not gonna leave over there until it's time to whip around. You have stepped, I already started turning. You can see part of my other shoulder at this point. Then I keep going, shuffle. I have already been basically facing the back, and then it's just a little half turn, jump onto the foot that is up, that is the foot you shuffled with, jump. And then you have, now it's really difficult to show this properly slowly, but that's the idea. So you have step, shuffle, jump toe. It does not change the foot. The foot you shuffled with is the one that you're jumping onto. I'm gonna be very, very clear. So you have step, shuffle, jump on it, toe. All right, and that's how you turn it. Let's try it on the left. So you step left, I've already started turning, you shuffle right, you jump on it, and then you tap. Let's try that again. You step, you shuffle, jump on it, tap. Now you shouldn't have your heels on the ground. This leg doesn't like being jumped on right now, so my heel's like, but you should have your heels up the whole time with this step. One more time on the left, just to give it a try. So you have step, shuffle, jump, and then it would continue. You could do two in a row, you could do five in a row if you wanted to. But yeah, that's the Maxie Ford. You have now learned the Maxie Ford, or you got to review the Maxie Ford, depending on why you came to this video. So that's really awesome. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and learned a lot. I love this step, and I love doing these step tutorials because it's really fun for me to just spend some time with one step. Because some of them I love to teach. Others I actually have issues with teaching with, and this helps me learn how to teach it better, which is cool too. So, as always, I will remind you that I have so many other step tutorials before I say the end of this video. I have lots of step tutorials, so if you're missing other tap steps that you're looking to learn or kind of forgot how to do, I have tons of them in a playlist. I will link it below. It's the same playlist that this video is in. And yeah, I'm glad that you guys were able to learn this with me today. And as always, thank you for dancing with me.